Thank you, Honourable Speaker, sir, and I thank Honourable Nath for the question. Honourable Speaker, sir, this subject of IUU has been discussed in one way or another in Parliament, but I will go through the subject that is being asked this morning. In general, the surveillance and the business of fishing vessels in Fiji waters is covered under three main headings. One is the legislative framework. Then we have monitoring, control, surveillance, and enforcement. Honourable Speaker, sir, to ensure an effective approach in managing our vast ocean from IUU, we must have a robust legislation that is fit for purpose, forward-looking, and address the distinctive variables that exist in our ocean space. The Offshore Fisheries Management Act of 2012 and its regulations of 2014 has the objective to conserve, manage, and develop the long-term sustainable use of all fisheries resources, and as such has the legal provisions to address these needs. For example, Part 5 of the Act, under licenses and authorizations, it provides the legal basis in which licenses are issued and also covers the need to have the needed permits to help track the fish chain from when it is caught until when it is eaten. Additionally, as I have alluded to, Honourable Speaker, sir, the Act provides provisions for monitoring, control, surveillance and enforcement. In the work undertaken by our fisheries observers, the monitoring exercise provides the critical scientific data that is needed to understand fishing trends and tuna stock. Through an advanced approach and as a complement to having observers on board vessels, the Ministry implements an electronic monitoring system that records all activities on the vessel. In fact, this fiscal year's budget has an allocation of 550,000 for the monitoring systems. The use of video footage, sightings, and observer report is used by the Ministry to identify illegal activities that occur on any fishing vessels in our waters. Moreover, Honourable Speaker, sir, through our licensing control mechanisms, there are conditions in place to track the movement of vessels and activities that enter Fiji waters. This includes the mandatory entry and exit notifications where vessel will have to report their location, fish on board, and their intention when entering Fiji waters. Honourable Speaker, sir, apart from this manual reporting, there are also mandatory requirements to assist vessel checks that are held on board all fishing vessels. These are called the Vessel Monitoring System, or VMS. This system works as a vessel tracker, similar to GPS, which are able to track using satellite reporting system housed at the Ministry of Fisheries and the Fiji Navy Regional Surveillance Center. Through this collaborative work with the Foreign Fisheries Agency, all vessel movement in Fiji is analyzed and monitored. If vessels are suspected of illegal fishing, these vessels are then tagged to indicate the need for thorough inspection and investigation during boarding and clearance exercises. Honourable Speaker, with an annual average of 1,200 foreign fishing vessels transiting through our waters or making port visits, it is vital that systems are in place to conduct relevant checks on these vessels. Fiji is fortunate that it undertakes a stringent boarding and inspection exercise that are undertaken by our enforcement officers. The boarding and inspection are either conducted out at sea, in port, or along the wharf, depending on the type of vessels that pass through our waters. If vessels are suspected to have conducted illegal fishing activities, the current law gives permission for our officers to seize the vessel and fish on board while investigations are conducted. On the basis of proving that an offence is being committed, the vessels are either fined, seized, or sanctioned through the court legal proceedings to recover the loss incurred by the government. Moreover, Honourable Speaker, sir, to address the vast ocean area, that needs constant surveillance. Fiji is in collaboration with regional members of the foreign fisheries agencies and conduct 5 annual surveillance operations throughout the year. These surveillance operations cover the EEZ and high seas in the Pacific region and use analyzed historical and real-time data to track fishing vessels that operate in the region. This operation is assisted by surface and aerial assets provided through the joint support of the United States, France, Australia, and New Zealand. In fact, Honorable Speaker, sir, our fisheries and naval officers have just completed one surveillance operation called Island Chief, in which we saw our officers conduct joint patrol in our waters on one of the ministry's operatives, just returning to shore from a 3-week stint in the HMZS Wellington. Additionally, through ship rider programs such as with the government of US and UK, our officers are now going on board US Coast Guard and UK naval vessels and conducting surface patrols in our EEZ. Honorable Speaker, sir, it is through such tools and platforms that Fiji is able to effectively manage fishing activities which occur within our waters. This, coupled with fit-for-purpose training for observers, enforcement, and prosecution officers, is what equips us to undertake the vital work needed to address IUU. I thank you, Honorable Speaker, sir.